Hey guys, it's ArtCast number 375, I think. Jeff Lafferty, of course. How's everybody doing out there? I'm just sitting here finishing up a commission for a guy. This piece is from the movie, what's it called? I think it's called The Thing from Outer Space. It's like a really old one, in black and white, and this is like the monster from The Thing. And I was going to watch it, and I found it, and I didn't get around to watching it yet, but it's like a little bit of a, you know, obscure one, I guess, or maybe it isn't, and I just missed out on it somehow, but I'm having fun with it for sure, and I actually want to watch it. I might watch it right after this ArtCast and check it out. It looks pretty cool. The monster guy is actually played by James Arness. I don't know if you guys recognize that name, but it's he was you know, Matt Dillon, like the Marshal in Gunsmoke. And you can kind of tell looking at his face a little bit once you know that. Anyway, I think it's coming out pretty good. It took me about 4 days to do it, I guess, total. Which was a little bit longer than I wanted, but I did it a little bit bigger. Did it, this one's like 11 by 14, I think. And that's about how long it takes me to do one of these. That size. But yeah, everything's going well. I know I haven't been on YouTube much lately, but I don't know if I have an excuse. I think I always say, you know, like I don't like when, you know, YouTubers get on and the first thing they do is start apologizing why they haven't been on YouTube, but I don't know, I just, after I got my computer working again and stuff, and I just felt like, I just didn't really feel like making videos, you know, and just took some time off, really. And I don't know, I think it was actually good because it kind of got my head into a good space, I think, you know. It just gave me some time to sort of look at what I do, you know, in my business, I guess, you know, like overall, like everything I do and how I make my money and all that kind of stuff, and just let me kind of stop and just think about it a little bit, you know, and think about like what I wanted to continue and what I didn't. And I actually wanted to think about that a little bit with YouTube, like whether I really wanted to keep going on making videos still and all that kind of stuff. And and it was just good to kind of like just take some time and think. I mean, I didn't take any time off. I was just drawing, you know, furiously, kind of trying to get the bills caught up and you know, just get back to where we had some money and stuff, and just make the rent and all that kind of stuff. And it worked. It worked out. You know, it was like a tough couple months, but I'm kind of finally starting to get towards the end of it, and it's good. You know, I'm thankful that I got through it. I was actually looking through my videos the other day, and I realized that my 3-year anniversary of quitting my job and striking out on my own again, trying to make my living as an artist, is coming up. I think it's the 14th of May is when I left. That might be wrong. It might be the 24th. I don't know. But basically in May is when I quit. And I know that because, like, you know, if you go back to the first ArtCast, that first ArtCast was, you know, like when I quit, basically. That was sort of the last day I went to work, and I haven't been back to work for 3 years now. I wonder if they miss me. No, I'm kidding. I'm sure. I didn't leave them without telling, without quitting, basically, so they knew I quit. But, you know, it's like in painting and construction, I could basically go back tomorrow if I wanted, you know, probably get my job back. Because that's just how that whole business is, you know. but I have it, you know, and I think it's cool. And it just kind of makes me realize I really did it, you know. Even though, you know, you're never completely out of the woods, it's always, you know, a struggle and all that kind of stuff. But, you know, it's the kind of struggle you want in your life, I think. I don't regret it, like, in the least. I absolutely think I made the right decision. And, yeah, I'm not looking to go back at all, you know. I was thinking about some of the stuff I mean, just, you know, when you do that kind of thing, like what kind of stuff you learn and stuff, you know. As far as, like, you know, what were some of the pitfalls and stuff, and I think one of the things that I had trouble with in the beginning I was going to say time management, but I actually don't think that was it. I think I had more trouble with that later on, once you kind of start to feel a little bit more safe, you know. Like that first, like, step out the door, that first couple months, I just was painting and drawing and drawing and drawing as absolute much as possible to get myself as far ahead as I could so that I couldn't sort of be caught and, you know, have to go back to work. And that worked, actually. But I was, like, working, you know, 24 hours a day for 2 months. I think I remember, like, that first week of being quit or whatever. And, because I immediately started kind of, like, really, like, looking at, like, how much money I had and, you know, how much money. Sorry, I was looking for my brush here. These brushes, it's funny, it's like they sure do wear out. I don't know if you guys can see what that is, but these little silver ones, they're called, I can't even read it now, it's kind of worn off, silver white. But they're like a synthetic brush, but I noticed that they, like, actually get shorter as I paint with them, you know? They really don't last more than, like, a couple weeks, and then I just absolutely have to get another one because there's just no tip left on it. But anyway. But I was going to say, like, when I left, though, I was just working, and I think, I can't really remember without, like, kind of going back and, like, trying to find, like, my file where I, you know, write down what I make and stuff. But I think, like, that first week I made, like, it was 300 and something, and then, like, the second week it was, like, you know, over 7 or something like that, which I'm not bragging, but it just shows, like, what kind of a panic I was in. I was just painting, you know, just like every cent. I just had to make as much as I could. And, you know, was just trying to get as many commissions and selling as much stuff on eBay as I could. And, you know, it's like that moment when you get your back up against the wall, you know, and you gotta figure it out, you know. You just go after it, you know, like a madman. That's what I did. But I think later on, though, I think if anything, if there's been stuff that's hurt me over the last, you know, 3 years, that's like the disorganization with, like, my money and stuff, just not keeping up with it. And just hang on a sec. Okay, I'm back. I just had to switch out the cards again. Switch out the cards on the camera, you know. What I was talking about was just, you know, like being disorganized about the money, not so much like not caring about it, but just not like I find that it's like I really need to, like, write down, like, what I make each day in, like, a book, you know. And, like, when you work a job and stuff, you're just not used to doing that. But that's, like, something I've been doing, you know, pretty consistently, but have fell off a couple times. And when I do that, I notice that's the one I have those months where I'm like scrambling at the end of the month to make enough money, because it's just, you know, that just that act of like just writing down, you know, what you made today on, you know, if you sold any prints or sold an original or got a commission or got a deposit for a commission or whatever, it just, you know, you just, you know, your mind just kind of automatically plans ahead, and you just are always kind of thinking about just where, you know, where, how it's going to work out that month, you know. And when I kind of get ahead, sometimes I get lackadaisical about that, and then I might not do it for, you know, a few days or 4 days or 5 days, and, you know, then you just kind of get, just start losing track a little bit. And I don't know, that's just something with me that helps me kind of, you know, work for myself, I guess. Which I guess, you know, realistically you should probably do that anyway. But, you know, I'm an artist, not a businessman, so. Or I mean, you know, I didn't go to business school or something, so, you know, my brain doesn't really think about money 24/7. It thinks about, you know, all the creative stuff I want to do, and not so much, you know, the business side of it. But, yeah, I don't know. It's been good. It's been good. I'm, like I said, I'm glad that I left when I did. And, you know, it feels good to kind of, I don't know, you know, when you get to these milestones or anniversaries or whatever, you know, it's kind of cool that I did the video on the day I left, you know, work or whatever, you know, or the first day I stayed home. So it's like, it's just a reminder whenever I go in there that, like, you know, oh, you know, the next year's coming up or whatever. And it's just, you know, it's, I don't know, you know, I can't help but think back, you know, on all the people who basically told me I was crazy, and a lot of them were back at, you know, my painting job, and I'm sure they're all back there still, and they probably still think I'm crazy, but, you know, I don't know, I haven't been to work in 3 years, so maybe I wasn't. I saw, this is kind of interesting, on, like, you know, Jeff Maricola has been doing some videos about that convention he's just went to called SpectrumCon, I think it's called, or something like that. It's like tied to that Spectrum book. And I noticed in one of his videos, like in the background of his booth, or maybe it was actually in some of his photos, I don't know. I'm in his like Facebook group, you know, he's got for, you know, I think it's called Fantasy Art Workshop or something like that. And it's a pretty good group, but I was, you know, he posted some photos in there, and I think it was actually in one of the photos, but like in, he just posted some photos of his booth at this con. And in one of the photos, there's this guy, Eric Olson. I can see like his art and his booth, like, you know, sort of in the back of Miracola's booth. So he was like boothing like next to him or something. And I used to know this guy like really well back in the day. He lived here in Colorado and was a really awesome painter. And actually I learned a lot about painting from him. And we were fast friends for a long time, but then eventually we had kind of a falling out and just kind of stopped talking and everything. But I thought it was kind of cool that I saw him in the video, because it was just nice to know that he's still out there, plugging away, doing some art, doing some painting, because he was really good, and he was super talented, and, you know, a lot of the stuff that just, like, happened between me and him was just, I don't know, it's like that young ego, jealousy kind of thing, I think, and I wasn't immune to it, he definitely wasn't immune to it either, and, you know, we got along, but we also didn't get along a lot of the times, so. But anyway, it was kind of cool, because I just hadn't heard or seen anything from a guy for, like, years, really. Not that I was really looking, but, you know. So it's just kind of cool. I like to see, you know, other artists do well. And I don't know, you know, like when I was younger, you know, the jealousy thing, sometimes I would fall into it with certain people and fight with them or become sort of rivals with them. And I think that that, you know, ultimately doesn't do anything for you. I think really and truly it just, all it does is just cause heartache. And I think that in a way, you know, you don't get the benefit from a relationship you might have with the people that you're rivaling against, you know, because if you're kind of, you know, fighting against them or whatever, I think that, you know, that it's probably because they're pretty good artists or, you know, have some sort of skill or knowledge that, you know, you should really be learning instead of wasting your time, you know, battling. So anyway, I don't know. I didn't have much to, didn't have any topic. I just thought, I'm just going to turn on the camera because I haven't done a video in forever. And I should get back on the schedule and start making videos again and all that stuff. I've got a couple more commissions this month. I mean, I actually got quite a few commissions. That's the thing, you know, like I made that one video talking about getting my commission list down to zero. And what I realize is you can't really ever get that thing to zero because, you know, you just get more commissions. And the more work you do, the more people want more stuff. So it's almost impossible, I think. But I did get about half of the ones that were on the list at the time done. I think the list is still, you know, at like whatever it was, 11 or something. But that's fine. But yeah, I wanna get a couple more pieces done, like right now, you know, since it's the end of the month and I just need to get them done. And then I really want to actually get back on my comic book and work on Berserkernaut again. I mean, I got sort of derailed with my computer problems. I'm not saying that was the only reason. I could have just, you know, fought through it, but I didn't. But, you know, it's just like I'm missing it. You know, I'm actually missing it. I want to get it done. I want to kind of prove to myself that I can still do comics. I want to, you know, hold the thing in my hand, and I actually kind of want to maybe submit it to Image and just see if I could even get back in the shops or something, you know, or maybe a couple other companies that I've found. And yeah, so that's my goal for this month, I guess. I don't know, it's not really a monthly goal, it's just what I'm planning on doing, you know. It's good to have plans, you know. It's good, that's something that I think is, as long as we're talking about this kind of stuff, I think that that is super, like, important in a way. Like, when you do, like, this business or any kind of art business, you gotta make some kind of goal where you have, like, a compelling future. You know what I mean? So, like, you know, saying like you want to be a famous artist is one thing, but like you've got to think like how are you going to make it work so that you're excited about actually getting there and doing that, you know, because it sucks when you get to a goal and you get bored with it or you get you know, it's like you realize it wasn't necessarily like what you want, you know. And I think that kind of happened to me a little bit, you know. You got to have something more than just like, okay, you know, this is how I'm going to make money. You got to sort of like think down the road from that and still want to achieve stuff even when you achieve your goal, so to speak, you know. Otherwise, you just kind of get into this. It kind of becomes drudgery sometimes, you know. I don't know if that makes sense, but that's another thing I've learned. So anyway, that's it. I want to wrap up. You can see the card's running out, my timer's running out, and all that stuff. I just want to say thanks for watching, guys, and see you next time.